Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, without further ado, welcome to another episode of Nowhere Nomad. And the hair is getting rather long at the moment. It's like nipple length when wet.
Sounds a bit dodgy, doesn't it?
But yeah, I mean, I'm looking like a Cocker Spaniel stroke King Charles Spaniel at the moment. Which is good, I guess, if you're going to enter Crofts. But yeah, I mean, other than that, I don't know what to do with it. It's just hanging all over the place, really. But I'm not going to cut it because I don't have enough money to get it cut. So, which brings me to my next point. I'm looking for a job at the moment, but obviously it's really difficult to look for a job while you're travelling. So I had my thumb out on the side of the road, like a cheap hooker the other day, hitching a ride. And it's amazing the people you meet, actually. I met two awesome people, Daryl and Pauline, and they've actually offered me to stay at their place while I look for work, which is brilliant, really. So I'm staying with them at the moment. And the other day they said, we're heading up to Taupo and, you know, around the Taronga and around all the mountainous area up there. Do you want to come? And I said, well, yeah, you know, I'll take my camera and I'll film it. So that's what I've done. Here's the footage. Enjoy!
What did you call it, Daryl?
Tiki touring.
Tiki touring.
Yeah.
So we're tiki touring at the moment. Myself, there's Daryl driving in the front, and there's Pauline there.
Hello.
And
they're the most super coolest, awesomest persons in the world.
Yeah, they really are.
And modest too.
And very super modest, yeah. Local yokels from...
not even, she's Dutch not even. And I'm an Aussie.
a Dutch and an Aussie who live in Rotorua and are taking me round. And I've actually found me a job, so they're super awesome people, really are. I can vouch for that. And we're just going up the mountains today, so yeah. So I'm in the central part of the North Island at the moment, by Lake Taupo, and we're at the southern end of Lake Taupo. And that distance over in there, that town you can see, is Taurangi. So there we are. Beautiful views. So here we are by the lakeside, and right in front of us is Mount Tongariro. And to our left is the new spring that's just shooting up in a vertical spout there. And over to the right is Kitatani Springs. So if I pan over here, right directly in front of me, you can see Mount Narahoe, which is actually Mount Doom. They used for Mount Doom in Lord of the Rings. So I'm actually in Mordor. So here we go, guys. I'm right on the mountain trail now. Look at that for a view. There's Mount Doom. That is Mount Doom from Lord of the Rings. Oh, it's freaking freezing.
As the blocks fall, incandescent dust trickles out. The finer dust particles remain suspended in the air, producing a reddish-brown smoke, which is very irritating to the eye. The whirling masses of molten lava, glowing bright orange, and enormous blocks of solidified lava make a spectacular sight as they rush down the mountainside. The biggest blocks thrown out during the 1954 eruption measured 15 meters across, about three times the size of this specimen. On the way down, we get splendid views of the eruption. Although there are no more lava flows, ash explosions increase in intensity during December and January after a lull of several months.
I love this Kiwi statue made of wood, looking directly across
to Mount Doom.
This I can kind of understand, hot coffee from a machine. But this, hot coffee to go in a can. I've never seen this before. And the cans are actually hot. That's weird. Oh, they're really hot. Why wouldn't you just get it from the machine? Why would you? Bizarre, just truly bizarre. So here we are at Makapoti Viaduct. It was built, well, the build started in 1905 and was completed in 1908, so it took 3 years to build. And I'm just up on the fence at the moment, and I can just see the bottom of it there. It looks like they've got some work going on, so they've got a canopy over the middle pylon. You can see the mist coming over the top of the hill.
So here we are at the other side of Mount Ruapehu. The ski lodge isn't open because there's not enough snow. It's kind of derelict.
It's so quiet. It's like a scene from Resident Evil. So here we are on Mount Ruapehu on the Tis but a scratch, sir.
We need to get him back now.
That's just spray. Finally found one. Kiwis crossing. Don't run them over. Welcome to Okuni, where adventures begin.
Home of the giant carrot. Yo, wouldn't that look tasty?
Look at these little chalets. They're brilliant. They're just little roofs. The Illuminati housing project. So here I am at Tangiwai, and this is where they had the rail disaster, Christmas Eve, 1953. And what actually happened is the crater lake up at Ruapehu burst its banks and came surging down this river and took the train and most of its passengers and broke the bridge. And there's the rebuilt rail bridge over there where the disaster happened. And this river was a raging torrent. It pulled the train and its passengers to their certain doom. So here's some photographs of the wreckage. This disaster actually killed 151 men, women and children. Christmas Eve 1953. What a tragedy. Here we are at the actual memorial. The train wreck. And these are the names around the base of all the people that lost their lives on that terrible day. 1953. This is pretty cool. The black dots that you can see in the rock are whole tree trunks that have just been caught in the pyroclastic flow of the volcano that's just turned to charcoal. Let's have a look. Oh, you can even see the ring. The rings, that's amazing. I'm going to take some of this and draw with it. That is so cool. The outside is rock.
And in the half light, you just get so much more detail than you do during full sun. It's beautiful.
There's no shadow.
So there's Narahoe over there, smothered in cloud. And over to your left, Ruapeo, the big boy. Beautiful, beautiful New Zealand. New Zealand is awesome. I've got to say, this is probably one of the top five sunsets I've ever seen. Probably, maybe even number one.
So guys, there you go. Narahoe, Ruapeo, the middle of the North Island. I'm finally here, Middle Earth, yes! Now, I'm still actually technically living in Rotorua, and Daryl has actually been a gem, and he's offered for me to come and work at his roofing company, which he's just started working at himself. So, on Monday, I'm going to start to be a roofer. Well, a roofer's lackey. I'm just going to be like lugging heavy stuff around, basically being a gopher. So we'll see how that goes. I've got to give a shout out at the moment to Gemma, to Alison, to Marta, and to Mumsy, of course. All of you guys have been sharing my videos consistently, so wah! Shout out to you. And as always, take care. I shall see you on the flip side for the next video. Whoopah!